everyone. It's Barbie. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, this is part two of the Come Thrifting with a Costume Designer series. My boyfriend is here today to interrupt the video and send a special message, apparently.
What are you doing?
I'm filming a video.
Oh,
yeah? Yeah. He's crazy. If you guys want to see a video with my boyfriend in it, today is not about him. This video is actually not about my... This video is not about my boyfriend. But if you want to see a video about him, I'll link it here. I did a video where I did a bundle for him, so if you want to watch that instead of this video that's not about him, you can watch that. Where we left off last, I had gotten a few things for the supporting character who doesn't care about his style at all, and the director did approve some of the basic tops that I got. A few were ixnayed. I think I'm going to try to find one more of those plain little collared shirts for him, and then I still need to find him a workout outfit. I still need to find him pajamas. It is very hard to shop for tall people, so especially at the thrift, I have been having very limited options with tall people at the thrift. Today we are continuing to look for those things for the supporting character, and then also I'm just gonna be browsing to see what I can find for the other character. She's a grandmother and wears very basic things. Again, this character also doesn't care about her style. She cares more about comfort and things like that. But I'm hoping that I get the lead character's measurements this week so that you guys can come thrifting with me for some more fun, stylish type outfits, because these first two characters that I'm sourcing for do not care about fashion, which is hard for me. It's actually a challenge when a costume designer has to thrift unfashionable things. It's kind of hard. I'm also figuring out that with certain characters that do have tough measurements, they're very tall, very long, it's helpful to go on Poshmark and Depop so that I can still shop secondhand, but I can look for very specific sizes from a wider source of secondhand clothing. So I would definitely recommend that if you're a costume designer out there that uses a thrift store as a source, but if you can't find stuff for your character's measurements, let's go. Also unrelated, but I did finally organize all of my crafts in this wall and desk here, and I'm just so happy with it.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feel, and I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. The sun's in my heart and I'm ready for love. Let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the place. Come on with the rain, I've a smile on my face. I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing, singing in the rain. Dancing in the rain, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm happy again. I'm singing and dancing in the rain.
It is a few days later. I will show you what I ended up getting from Goodwill for another supporting character, the mother of the lead, essentially. So essentially for this character, we're going for a look that's pretty comfy casual, like kind of classy, but doesn't like totally care about her style sort of thing. So I got this, we've got a simple kind of turtleneck long sleeve, and then we've got kind of a simple light blue sweater. This one kind of went well with one of my inspo photos that I had for her. Also got, I think this one is really gonna be a winner. It's a cream, very simple. This looks like, and looks like an older woman would wear this. I think this is a great option for her. It's a nice cream color. It's pretty cozy, good for winter time. Love that vibe. This I like because I feel like we could use this for multiple types of scenes. My Tamagotchi is making noise. Hold please, do you wanna see my Tamagotchi? How cute is my little Tamagotchi? Okay, but this is great because I can use this for multiple purposes. I think she could wear this in like a bedtime scene when she's like lounging, getting ready for bed, but she could also wear this like with an outfit. It's just a very long, black, simple cardigan. So I feel like this is a great statement piece for her. So found just some plain black pants for her because again, she dresses very simple, very comfortable. These are just some plain pants that again, could also go for loungewear or could go for pajamas or could go for everyday look. I'm trying to find multi-purpose pieces for her because this character is gonna be inside for a lot of scenes that she's in. So she might not be wearing anything sort of fancy. So I'm trying to find things that are multi-purpose for lounging and sleepwear. I also found this shirt as an option for that supporting character that I was thrifting for. Thinking of this piece for the shirt that's like slightly different that he's going on a date in. That is it for part two of Come Thrifting with a Costume Designer. I hope you guys had fun shopping for some supporting characters with me. I actually just got the measurements for the leads, so I will be doing a lot more thrifting soon, and of course I'm gonna take you guys along with me, and I'm so excited because one of the leads, she's actually fashionable, so I will get to put together some really fun outfits, which I'm pumped about. Anyways, if you're new to my channel here, I make a lot of thrifting, secondhand fashion content. Please subscribe, join the Bear community, like, comment, subscribe, please. Thank you. I never know how to end videos.